So, are there any eye exercises to help with dry eyes? Specifically, we are talking about blinking exercises, which have been shown in several studies to have a positive effect on both the signs and the symptoms of dry eye disease, with the most recent publication just coming out here in 2025. Now, the whole reason eye doctors have been researching blinking exercises and if they help is because it's well known that a lot of people with dry eye tend to have issues with their blinking, especially if you're somebody who sits in front of a computer screen or a tablet or even a smartphone periodically throughout the day, as it's well known that people, when staring at a computer screen, we tend to hyperfocus and blink not only less than we would in normal conversation, but we tend to have incomplete blinks, meaning that our eyelids only kind of come down about halfway or three quarters of the way and never fully blink completely closed, which means a portion of the eye is constantly exposed to the environment, and that encourages faster evaporation and dryness of the ocular surface. So really the whole point of doing blinking exercises is to encourage normal, healthier blinking habits and to improve dry eye symptoms. Now there's two different protocols for doing blinking exercises. The first protocol came out in a study in 2021, which honestly is pretty simple. It involves simply just from looking straight ahead to closing the eyes gently and completely for 2 seconds. You then open your eyes and then you repeat that, again closing the eyes gently for 2 seconds, followed by a tightening and squeezing of the eyelids. Now, if you're following along, an important thing to note is that you don't want to scrunch the face like I'm doing right here. You try to just close and tightly squeeze the eyelids without engaging the cheeks, the forehead, or the nose. Because if you scrunch the face like this, then you're going to be increasing the chance of developing more wrinkles around the nose, the forehead, and the ocular adnexa. The whole point of squeezing the eyelids closed for 2 seconds is to help strengthen the orbicularis oculi muscle, specifically the superior portion, which controls about 90% of your blink action. Now, in this study in 2021, they had participants do these simple eye exercises once every 20 minutes throughout the entire day for 4 weeks. It's quite a bit of time of doing that. I personally think it's somewhat unrealistic to do that all day long. However, they did have positive results, even though there technically was no control group. I will say that I think it is pretty simple to do these exercises, and I think it's a great habit to have if you're somebody who's in front of a computer screen throughout a lot of the day. I say that because it's generally recommended to take a break in front of the screen every 20 minutes anyway, just to get up, improve your posture, get a drink of water, use the restroom, and just give your eyes a break. This is just, again, a good rule of thumb to help improve eye strain and productivity, and incorporating some blinking exercises, I think, is a pretty simple thing to do. Especially considering the study did show improvement in dry eye symptoms, as well as better rates of incomplete blinking. They actually reduced how many incomplete blinks people had. Now, the newest study that was just published on blinking exercises just came out here in 2025, and they added 2 new steps to this already existing protocol. They did the exact same protocol that we just reviewed, but they added these 2 extra steps. They added a kind of a what they call a dazzle eyes movement, which the best way I can describe this is sort of a squint. You're purposely squinting the eyes for 2 seconds in order to strengthen the lower orbicularis oculi muscle. Again, the upper orbicularis oculi does about 90% of the heavy lifting, but even if you put your fingers on the lower eyelid and try to squint for 2 seconds, you can feel the contraction of that lower portion of the eyelids. So they do this dazzle or kind of squint motion for 2 seconds, and then they do what are called fox eye movements. The fox eye movement is where you place fingers on the outsides of your eyelids and you sort of position the upper eyelid in an upward position. This sort of isolates the lower orbicularis oculi to do more movement while the upper portion of the eyelid stays in place. That way, when you're blinking, the lower eyelid does more of the movement and you can strengthen that lower orbicularis oculi. So this study, all in all, did the protocol from the first study where they close the eyes for 2 seconds gently, open the eyes, close the eyes again, squeeze the eyes. Then they do the dazzle eyes, or kind of the squinting procedure. And then they did a fox eye, where you lift the eyes up and blink the eyes. And they did this full cycle 5 times, so 5 reps. And I think of that as waking up in the morning, and then each meal, breakfast, lunch, dinner, and then again at bedtime. And they had the participants do this while also using an eye drop, same those 5 times a day. And they compared this to a control group that just used the eye drops alone. Now, this study only ran for 3 days, which you may think, okay, three days is not that long, but it actually showed pretty significant effects, and that helps me as a professional think, wow, even just doing this for 3 days can have significant improvements on their dry eye symptoms, their discomfort, their eye strain, and improved the tear film stability, which is super important with dry eye disease. Another interesting finding from the study is they showed improved palpebral fissure height, which is how wide open the eye is showing from top of eyelid to bottom of eyelid. We're only talking about like a 1 millimeter difference in palpebral fissure height, but still was found to be statistically significant. So if you do these blinking exercises, will you notice a change with how wide open your eyes look and having more of a youthful appearance? Kind of a high stretch for that, but I do think it at least implies from this research that something is going on with the eyelid muscles, and at the very least, improvements in dry eye parameters. I also really like the fact that they had a control group that was just using eye drops so that we can compare and basically show that doing these exercises has a therapeutic benefit of improving the tear film stability, having improved discomfort and eye strain, but also improving the incomplete blink rate, right? For people like myself, who I know I don't blink 100% of the way a lot of the time, again, it encourages me, hey, doing this, there is a way I can improve that. I also like the fact that it was just 5 times a day and not every 20 minutes as the first study had published. It just seems more realistic to me. Now, hopefully knowing how to do these blinking exercises helps you out. In addition to doing these blinking exercises, an app I wanted to mention that I've been testing out on my desktop and laptop computers is an app called Bliink, B-L-I-I-N-K. This is an app on my computer that tracks my blink rate. It tracks how frequently I am blinking while staring at the computer screen. It also tracks my posture in case I happen to decrease my blink rate or I end up slouching throughout the day. It can track that and then give me a gentle reminder on screen so that I can be more aware and conscious of my positioning and my blinking, which I think is a really helpful reminder in case I'm not blinking enough and need to take a moment to blink my eyes a few times, or just reminding me to get out of my bad posture, because that also is related to not only back and neck strain, but is also related to eye strain. You can even adjust what sort of reminders it gives you and how frequently they show up. They even have certain exercises and guides on how to do exercises and stretches for things like your neck and your shoulders. In fact, a lot of businesses are now using this app to help improve posture and productivity for their workers. If you think this sounds like something you might want to try, they do have a free trial. Plus, if you end up liking it, then you can save 10% by using my discount code, which I'll put in the description below. Again, something I've been testing out and enjoying, so I thought I'd mention it here in case it's something that might help you too. But from here, I'd love to hear from you in the comment section. Have you ever tried blinking exercises before, and what kind of results have you had from it? An additional question, if you happen to be another eye care professional practicing in the dry eye space, I know some eye doctors have debated in the past if eye exercises are really that valuable, but with this new study that came out, does it change your opinion or thoughts on it? Again, love to hear ya. Either way, since I just mentioned the importance of knowing your posture and its relation to your neck muscles affecting eye strain and discomfort, check out my other videos coming up here to the side, all about proper ergonomics and screen posture, including a video on computer glasses and when those may be an advantage over using some other type of pair of glasses. Otherwise, thanks so much for watching, keep an eye on it, and we'll see you in that next video.